Hi friends, this is Krishna Raj Rao, the urban Naxal. Today I don't want to talk about Modi, I don't want to talk about BJP, I don't want to talk about Delhi riots or CAA or NRC. Today I want to talk about the more overwhelming and immediate issues presented by coronavirus to Mumbai specifically and to the entire urban India in general. There are a few facts about India that Indians themselves are only subliminally aware of. They are only aware at the back of their mind, but they have not articulated the problem. And these problems are going to prove critical when the coronavirus crisis hits. Critical thing that I want to talk about, where system collapse is, I should say, possible, likely and imminent, is in the medical sector. Private nursing homes, etc. are completely freaked out by the coronavirus and they are more likely to collapse under pressure than to come up to meet the challenge of coronavirus and the increased number of patients. Let me elaborate on this. I spoke to a doctor recently who has his own private nursing home, and he said that his way of dealing with patients nowadays is he has told his staff to expeditiously get rid of the patients who are coughing. It doesn't matter who else is waiting in queue, but their instructions are to immediately take the patients who are coughing and give them whatever palliative medications are possible and send them on their way. They don't want people who have cough and cold symptoms to hang around in their waiting room, which is in a way a smart thing, because one COVID patient among 20 other patients might infect all of them. They may also make the nursing home staff and patients nervous. So this is a useful and important step. However, I have also received news of private nursing homes, hospitals and polyclinics more or less running on skeleton staff. The doctors don't report for work. The nurses and ward boys aren't reporting for work. Either they have been told to stay away or they have started staying away on their own because they don't want to come face to face with people who are coughing and sneezing and possibly may have COVID-19. India's private nursing homes are all unlikely to stay open when the flow of COVID-19 patients comes in. And India's, I'm specifically talking about the urban sector here. India's medical sector is largely privatized. I would say to the extent of 70-80% of all the bed capacity is privatized. And privatized hospitals and nursing homes have little to no interest in dealing with patients who are considered to be highly contagious and whose presence in their hospital can lead to major complications. Private nursing homes, clinics, etc. want to make money, but they don't want the problems that go with it. For example, if there is a COVID patient who is traced back to their hospital, then there is every possibility that doctors and nurses and medical staff may be quarantined or may be asked to stay home. They will ask the entire nursing home to close down if it's a small one. So for this reason, I don't think any private nursing homes have the interest to entertain COVID patients. The ICUs that are available ordinarily to patients of all ailments would become unavailable during this crisis So intensive care units becoming unavailable to patients of, let us say, diabetes and heart disease and so on, because of closure of these, voluntary closure or enforced closure, whatever, but closure of these nursing homes, etc., would actually take a lot of India's urban medical capacity out of the equation. So just when you need them most, the urban capacity will actually disappear. And since private nursing homes and private nursing homes, polyclinics, etc., etc., are actually around 80-90% of our capacity in Mumbai, especially catering to the middle class and higher class who feel that they don't want to go to public hospitals, they don't like to bear the humiliation, imagined humiliation of going to hospitals, public hospitals, and sitting in queue for those doctors. They like to, you know, patronize only the private nursing homes, etc., which often are terribly understaffed. They don't have the right kind of staff. Their nurses are not really trained nurses. And there is every likelihood that they will not do anything at all for the COVID-19 patients. And in fact, in this moment of great need, all of these private nursing homes and the medical staff, everybody, is most likely to just plain disappear, just stay at home, just lock down, or reject the COVID patients on one pretext or another. In fact, even not only COVID patients, but even patients with other ordinary ailments, more routine ailments like diabetes and heart disease, will be neglected during the next 2 or 3 months. That is my reading of India's urban medical sector and the private medical sector. Even well-known large hospitals, I don't want to name them, the large hospitals which are very prestigious, hospital chains, etc., are likely to exhibit this kind of behavior. And India's encounter with COVID-19 is likely to lead to many, many more patients either lying at home without hospital care or lying pathetically in the hospital corridors, waiting for an ICU bed and possibly dying on the floor of the hospitals, in the hospital waiting rooms or corridors. If you think that this is a far-fetched scenario, let me tell you that growing up in Ahmedabad, I have seen the scenes of people lying, dying, puking, shitting in the hospital corridors and waiting rooms unattended, and it was a miserable state of affairs simply because of epidemics of diseases like cholera which were prevalent at the time. Whenever such epidemics strike, my general observation is that the Indian medical profession has been cowardly in response, has not risen to the occasion. I think the entire philosophy of the Indian medical profession, Indian medical professionals, is every man for himself. If you are not going to get money, if you are only going to get trouble, then you don't want to do that activity at all. This is the kind of mentality that I think Indian medical professionals have, and more particularly the ones in the cities and in the private sector. One of the reasons I am making this very grim prognosis is that we have a terrific shortage of genuine ICU beds, genuine ICU wards in places like Mumbai. There are plenty of ICUs where they will provide more or less routine care to post-surgical patients, etc. It is not really ICU. It is not really ICU in the sense of dealing with a crisis patient. The number of ventilators in Mumbai is probably woefully, and in fact, I'm not even saying probably, I'm saying this with a certainty, is woefully inadequate to meet the requirements of a crisis. And so what you're going to have is the scenes of patients being triaged. That is, patients being told, sorry, we don't have a free ventilator. Especially aged patients who may take up the ventilators for many days and who may require intensive medical care will probably not receive them. Maybe a few young middle-aged people may get it, and that too if you are influential. The Indian style of triage is, if you are influential, if you are wealthy, if you are well connected, if you are the relative of a minister or an MLA or an MP or a rich man, then you are likely to get medical care, because those guys, the influential MLAs and MPs and corporators, will phone the hospital directors and deans. The poor who are not influential, or people who don't have connection with political parties, are most likely to be triaged. This is Indians' way of triage, and it is merciless, it is brutal. When the crisis hits, I'm afraid this is what is most likely to happen.